Greetings to one and all. This is our project Smart Helmet, and this project is basically made for the factory workers and the workers who work in mines and industries, as we know that they face various issues and we are there to help them. We have made various features to solve their problems, and now he will be talking about the features.
So as stated by my partner, many of the issues which are faced by these workers, one of them is heat stroke. Another is they are not able to contact their supervisor as well as they face many other issues. For example, they have too much heat and they also can't contact. The SDG goal of UN, United Nations 1, then 9 and 11 also talk about these, about the good health a human being needs, how about the economic growth we have to go, and a sustainable society. When we, according to the British Council of Data, if we see 3 to 4 workers every day in India die due to the mishappenings and also due to the services they don't have. In this helmet, what we are providing is, this helmet we have built as in, will provide light. We have fans, in this that can be operated through this device.
Basically right now it states that the helmet is inactive because the pins right here, they are not connected together. So while we connect them together, it means that the worker is wearing the helmet, and helmet only functions when the worker is wearing the helmet. So basically we have made an operating system that the worker can use to interfere between the supervisor module.
Now let me explain all the components here. The first component we have is MQ135 gas sensor. It is used to detect harmful gases like ammonia. For example, there are various tragedies like Bhopal gas tragedies which happen due to gas. So it helps to prevent that. Then we have humidity and temperature sensor here. It is used to detect how hot or how cold a place is. So it can send a signal to the receiver module which would be with the supervisor. Then we have an accelerometer or gyroscope here. It is used to detect how fast or how slow a person is going, or if they are stationary or not. Then we have the Arduino Nano. It is the brain of the whole project, and it helps us to detect all the components and if they have a problem or not. Then we have HC05 Bluetooth module, which through which Arduino Nano sends the signal, and the signal is detected by the receiver module here. Then I would
So, as shown by my partner, this is the module. Now, here it shows the temperature. Also, it also shows if there is a gas leak. It will by clicking 3 times, it can send SOS that to the supervisor, which we are planning also, and as in making it automate, and also that would send an automatic message to the emergency services, which would call them. We are planning to have GPS and NAVIC, Indian NAVIC system integrated in this, because as we saw last year in the tunnel tragedy that happened in October, in that many of our workers were stuck in the tunnel for days and days, and they could not get out because there was no communication. We are planning to have get both two-sided communication that would help help the workers to tell the problems and also contact other people.
Sleep detection.
These are basically sleep detection glasses, and they have an infrared sensor which detects if a person blinks his eyes for more than 3 seconds, and it vibrates the helmet so that the person wakes up and doesn't get into an unnecessary accident.
Let's just show you a practical.
Thank you. We have also filed a patent for this, and it is in the due process, and we have also won awards at IIT Bombay as well. Thank you.